going, guys? Me, Dan from DanCarFilms here. Welcome back to another episode of Madden 17 New York Giants franchise right here. We're going to be releasing Orleans Darkwell, Byron Stingley, just a whole bunch of players that we really don't need. Kelvin Shepard here. This might be a little bit of a surprise, but, you know, they signed Keenan Robinson over the offseason for a reason right here. We're also going to sign Ryan Seymour to be one of our backup guards and also Dylan Farrell. And we're going to kick out, this is going to be also Kevin Seymour right here in the secondary. But yeah, we're going to kick out Bobby Hart out to right tackle. So he moves from a guard to tackle, and we fill his spot with two guard signings. And we're also going to move Dylan Farrell over to right guard and make him a run blocker like he is. But anyway, here we are in week three. It is the New York Giants versus the Washington Redskins. And this is a huge home game for us. This, you know, we can pretty much say to our division, if we win this game, hey, we beat the Redskins. We're here to make the playoffs. As look at that, they are 23rd in offense, 24th in defense. We're 10th in offense and 5th in defense. We're both 1-1. So this is a pretty good game, but we are at home, like I said, and we have a pretty good chance of winning this game. The Redskins aren't that big of a threat, but I mean, what they did in real life, they won in real life. So this should be an interesting game. You should be curious to see what happens. This is pretty big for us if we can go ahead and beat the Redskins, because we already lost to the Cowboys. So, I mean, if we lose to this team, then we're definitely not making the playoffs. So this is pretty much a must-win situation to show the coaching staff that the Giants can possibly make the playoffs, as this is Eli Manning right here. And look at Kirk Cousins firing up his offensive line. Hopefully they can block one of the best defensive lines in the league, led by Olivier Vernon. And we are underway in this Sunday afternoon, 1 o'clock. And this is going to be DeSean Jackson taking a knee in the end zone, and out comes Kirk Cousins. Three touchdowns, one pick, 60.6% completion ratio, and 491 yards. That's okay, not great, but anyway, this is going to be Sims off the right side for a nice first down run. That is going to be a gain of 7 yards. Play action fake to Sims right here. Cousins dumps it down to him, and he's going to pick up the first down. First and 10, Jackson in motion. Cousins out of the single back set. I don't even know what I'm saying. This is Vernon Davis with a nice catch right there. And that's right, Jordan Reed and Vernon Davis, they are the pair of tight ends on this team, and they can make you pay, especially Jordan Reed, the number one, pretty much the number one receiver on this team. As right here, we're going to take a look at their offense. Offensive line is led by Trent Williams right there at left tackle, one of the best left tackles in the entire league. And of course, Jordan Reed right there at tight end. He is a mismatch in the making. So, I mean, it's going to be hard to cover these guys, but hopefully we can do it. Third and 12, he's going to lob this one out of bounds, intended for Pierre Garçon. That was Janoris Jenkins on the coverage, and they're going to boot this one deep to the 22-yard line, and which brings out Eli Manning. Five touchdowns, one pick, 638 yards. So he is way better than Kirk Cousins, and hopefully he can prove that today, as this is Rashad Jennings out of the backfield. And look at this offensive line right here. Weston Richburg, Justin Pugh, and pretty blah everyone else. And this is going to be Odell Beckham Jr., Rashad Jennings, and it's just a very good, talented offense, but not a great offensive line. Second and 8 underneath the Hakeem Nicks. And Nicks, the free agent acquisition, the veteran, picks up the first down. Handoff Jennings up the middle for a very short gain of about 2. Now let's take a look at this Redskins defense. Very blah defensive line, but look at this linebacking core. Will Compton, middle linebacker, is a very good middle linebacker, very athletic. And then Josh Norman there in the secondary, Brashad Breeland, and D'Angelo Hall. But they also got Ryan Kerrigan and Junior Gallette, and the two best pass rushers as outside linebackers in the league, pretty much. I mean, they're up there with Justin Houston, Khalil Mack. They're up there with all of them. And, yeah, Ryan Kerrigan is going to be a very tough one to block, as on third and one, that is Jennings powering up the middle in a huge hole, but that is going to be coming back because of Larry Donnell's hold. Third and 11, play action fake to Vereen. We look over the middle to Victor Cruz, and Victor Cruz with a very nice catch sets us up with a first and 10 right here underneath the Donnell. Donnell gets us down close to a first down marker. Play action fake to Jennings. We look deep to Odell Beckham Jr. We lob one up, and Beckham Jr. comes down with it. No, he doesn't. His foot was out of bounds, and that just sucks. Third and one, Jennings right up through the middle, and he's going to pick up the first down. This is Donnell unable to hang on after a hit. Second and 10, another play action fake. We are looking deep again. Actually, no, we're not. This is going to be underneath the Will Tye, and Will Tye, the second string tight end, gets us down to the 25-yard line. First and 10, another play action fake. We are just destroying them here with these play actions. Up to Beckham, and that is going to be broken up by number 47. I'm not sure who that is, but that was very good against one of the best wide receivers in the league. And it's going to be a penalty on Greg Toler here. This is going to be a handoff Vereen off, or not, sorry, not Vereen, Jennings off the right side. He has three rushes for 11 yards, and we're just going to keep trying to feed him the ball here, get us down close. This is third and inches. We're under pressure. We're down. Sacked. That is Golston with the sack. And this kick is almost blocked as we take a 3-0 lead. We're going to boot this one deep now with 40 seconds left to go in the first quarter. This is DeSean Jackson back to return, and he's going to kneel right in the middle of the Giants logo. First and 10. Handoff Sims, and Sims is crushed by Jason Pierre-Paul in the backfield. 4 rushes for 3 yards for him. Slow start. Jackson with all the space in the world. He breaks away from Landon Collins and is brought down by Dominic Rogers-Cromartie. That could have been very bad. Davis in motion on first and 10. Sims up the middle, and he's going to get a nice gain of about 4 yards. Sims again up the middle. This is going to be a short gain. Once again, third and 2. Another handoff, and he's going to be stopped by Olivier Vernon and a whole bunch of Giants as well. This one is going to be booted deep down to the 18-yard line. Play action fake on first and 10. Manning under pressure. He pump fakes, and he's just going to throw this one away. He was trying to get the defensive tackle to quit on the play, but he didn't. And, yeah, he had to throw that one away. This is going to be Jennings stopped in the backfield. Actually, no, for a very short game. This is going to be Hakeem Nicks with a very clutch catch to pick us up the first down. Handoff right here to Rashad Jennings. Jennings gets a huge block. Jennings down the field to the 20, to the 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Rashad Jennings again is just a beast. 71-yard touchdown, and he has been really doing good for us here as we take a 10-0 lead with 7 minutes left to go in the second quarter. This one is going to be booted deep to Pierre Garçon, and Garçon is just going to end up taking a knee. So this brings Kirk Cousins back onto the field. Handoff Sims again. Sims getting a lot of work right here. He's going to be brought down by our pretty good defensive line, but Sims gets a nice first down run right there. That was a slip up. Jackson in motion. Another handoff to Sims to the outside, but that's Darian Thompson getting into the backfield along with Jonathan Hankins. This shut that down. Cousins feels the heat, dumps it down quick to Garçon, and Garçon gets a gain of 3. Third and 7. This is dumped out to the left Sims, and he's brought down by Keenan Robinson and Dominic Rogers-Cromartie, and we're going to receive this one deep in our end zone, so we're just going to take the fair catch here. He brings the ball out to the 20-yard line. First and 10. This is Jennings getting stopped for a loss of 1. Second and 11. Under pressure, he fires this one out to Cruz. It's tipped up in the air by Greg Toler and picked off by Josh Norman. That was just very unfortunate. It wasn't Manning's fault. It was just Cruz unable to hold on to it from the hit by Greg Toler. Look at Snacks getting in the backfield, stopping Sims. Third and 12. Cousins looks deep, floats one over the middle, and it's caught by Josh Doxson down at the 13-yard line. First and 10. Cousins now over to the right side and is going to be dropped by DeSean Jackson. Second and 10. Cousins has a little bit of time to throw the ball, and he's just going to put this one through the uprights. His intended target was Jordan Reed. He was a little bit under pressure right there by Olivier Vernon. Third and 10. Sims is stopped again in the flat. That is Darian Thompson coming down from his free safety position to stop that one. And on fourth and 10, they're just going to have to settle for the field goal as we're going to get the ball back here with a minute 56 left. Three timeouts. We should be able to make something happen, but this is going to be a terrible run back by Dwayne Harris. He should have just kneeled it as he's down at the 17-yard line. Will Compton, no one picked him up, and Eli Manning gets destroyed. Second and 18, under pressure here. It's almost picked off by Greg Toler again after a deflection. Third and 18, Manning's going to drop back in his end zone. Pressure by Ryan Kerrigan, and he's actually going to throw this one out of bounds. And intentional grounding in the end zone. That is going to be a safety on the New York Giants. And just like that, Washington gets the ball back with pretty good field position here. And they're down only 5 points, so a touchdown puts them up 2. So we got to stop them here. They have a minute 20 to go down the field. This one is almost caught by Garçon. Great play by Janoris Jenkins to break that one up. Second and 10. This one is actually going to be caught by Garçon. A huge hit by Collins, but somehow Garçon holds on. First and 10. Cousins underneath the Reed, and Reed with his first catch of the day, I think. The main target has been shut down. So far, this is Sims underneath, and Sims gets them the first down. First and 10. Cousins on the 28. He's going to fire this one up to Josh Doxson, and he gets them down to the 2-yard line. They're going to try to make something happen here. Fake to the fullback, out to Sims, and Sims is going to be stopped by Jason Pierre-Paul and Devin Kennard. And on second and goal from the 1, their right tackle, Morgan Moses, is going to false start. And just like that, that backs him up 5 yards. Second and goal. Cousins is going to throw this one through the uprights again. I don't think he knows what sport he's playing. Third and goal. He's going to fire a laser to Josh Doxson. And Keenan Robinson was unable to get there in time to shut down that pass. So just like that, they take a lead. But there's also going to be a running into the kicker penalty. And they're just going to decline that on Landon Collins, who's having a pretty rough game so far, and they're just going to take their extra points. So now they're up 12-10, and Harris is just going to fair catch this one. It goes out the back of the end zone. This is Jennings off the right side. Jennings is going to spin away. He's going to be brought down for a gain of 4, 2nd and 6. Manning looks underneath the Donnell. Donnell tries to break away from Will Compton, but Will Compton is all over that. 3rd and 2. Manning looks over the middle of the field. It's caught by Beckham. Beckham has space, but this is going to be Josh Norman catching up to him along with D'Angelo Hall to shut him down. And we attempt a 50-something yard field goal, and that is going to be Josh Brown's first miss of the season as he shanks it wide right. That was unfortunate. We almost had the lead right there, but this is going to be Dwayne Harris almost breaking one. He gets us up to the 30-yard line. Nice effort right there. Jennings off the right side. He's going to try to break away. But, yeah, if we would have kicked that field goal, we would have been up one right now. But we, at least we have the ball back anyway as we are shut down right there. 3rd and 8. Play action. Manning looks over, and it's going to be caught by Odell Beckham Jr. at the 45-yard line. It was almost picked off by the linebacker. That was a very risky throw. 1st and 10, caught by Cruz, and Cruz gets us a gain of 15. 1st and 10, again, underneath the Hakeem Nicks. He's just finding everyone right now. Eli Manning is 2nd and 8. Play action fake. Manning looks deep. It's caught by Odell Beckham Jr. over D'Angelo Hall, one of the better defensive backs in the league. He is also a veteran. And just like that, Beckham beats him and gives us the lead, 17-12. And we're going to give them the ball back and see what they can do. Hopefully we can stop them again. And hopefully we can get a score. Garcon kneels it in the end zone. 1st and 10. Off the right side. This is Sims. He's going to be stopped by Devin Kennard, who just... he just might as well make a home in the backfield because he spends half his life there. 2nd and 11. This is going to be Sims with a huge play. Collins is unable to get him, but Dominic Rogers-Cromartie catches up, and they're down at the 26-yard line. That was a huge run by Sims. Now this is Jones up the middle, and Jones, the man they promised the starting job, he's a little bit salty. He's trying to prove why he should have the starting job over Sims. But anyway, 3rd and 1. This is Cousins under pressure. He's just going to have to throw this one out. That was Olivier Vernon all over him there. That could have been potentially bad. But he's just going to throw this one away and settle for the field goal, which puts them in. A field goal would win it for them, pretty much. So this is Dwayne Harris back to return from inside his end zone. He's going to take this one out to the 26-yard line, 1st and 10. Manning looking to pass. He's going to throw this one to Larry Donnell for a gain of about 8. 2nd and 3. Someone in his motion. That was, we're going to find out in a second. No, we're not. That is going to be a sack by the defensive lineman. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. 3rd and 9 again. This time it's Ryan Kerrigan in the backfield. No, it was the same guy. The same guy is just destroying John Jerry and Marshall Newhouse, and we are just struggling to block anyone here as this is Jackson trying to set up some sort of huge return. He's going to be brought down by Keenan Robinson, but there's a flag on the play. It's going to be a block in the back on Duke Anaicho, the safety that they brought. Look at Sims here on this first down run. He breaks away from Cromartie, but he stumbles out of bounds. He has 12 rushes for 72 yards. That is pretty good. This is going to be 2nd and 5. He was unable to go anywhere right there. 3rd and 3. He's going to be brought down by Damon Harrison. Snacks, they like to call him, in the backfield, and that is going to set up a punt for them. And we're going to try to return this one. This is going to be Dwayne Harris back to return from inside his own 10. He's going to bring this one out to the 27-yard line. 1st and 10. Hand off Jennings right up the middle. And Jennings is going to try to power forward. That is a nice gain of about 8 yards. 2nd and 3. Off the right side. Jennings again. He's going to be stopped by Ryan Kerrigan. However, 3rd and 2. Manning, this is crucial for us to pick this up. And Donnell comes up clutch. We need to put points up on the board right here. 1st and 10. Hand off Jennings. He gets a huge hole, but he's brought down by the safety. For a gain of 6, 2nd and 4. This is Jennings again. He gets the first down after jumping on John Jerry's back. That was a huge play right there. Huge athletic play. And right here, Manning under pressure. He's going to run right into a sack. That is going to be Baker with the sack. 2nd and 21. We're looking for the screen right here. That is blown up all over the place by D'Angelo Hall. 3rd and 24. We're trying to get something going. It's up to Beckham. Nix. And Nix is unable to hang on after the coverage by Brashad Breeland. And on 4th and 24, we're just going to have to punt this one away. And look at this coffin kick as we get it inside the 10. There's Eli Apple there to down it at the 9. 1st and 10. Cousins is going to find Jackson underneath. And Jackson gets him up to the 15-yard line. 2nd and 4. Cousins feels the pressure. He's just going to dump this one deep to DeSean Jackson. 1st and 10 again. Cousins looks underneath. It's just this underneath passing game. This is Sims out of the backfield. 2nd and 7. And he looks deep, short again. Jackson is unable to hang on though after the hit. 3rd and 7. This is crucial for them to pick it up. And he overthrows a wide open Charles Sims. What was Kirk Cousins thinking? They needed to pick that up if they wanted to stay in this game. Now all we need to do is just milk the clock, as this is Dwayne Harris back to return. He's unable to juke anyone out, but he brings the ball up to the 29-yard line. Hand off Jennings. We're going to show them some power football right here, as that should be a late hit as the guy came flying in very late. This is almost intercepted by the defensive lineman as it went off the back of the head of Weston Richburg's. Third and eight. Beckham with a huge clutch catch on the curl route. First and 10. We look deep to Cruz, and Cruz with a huge catch over Brashad Breeland and D'Angelo Hall as they have struggled a little bit today. What a clutch catch by Victor Cruz. Second and 6, we're lobbing this one deep to Beckham, and that's going to be batted away by Greg Toler. Nice play right there. Third and 6, we're going to try to find Beckham again, but Breeland on the coverage, and Breeland breaks that up. So we're going to have to settle for a field goal as Manning is really trying to force the ball down the field here. He should have just checked down a couple times and just taken the easy yards. This is Garcon out of his end zone. Garcon is going to take this one up to the 24-yard line, not quite to the 25. First and 10. Cousins under pressure is just going to float this one out of bounds. That was Hankins with the pressure. Second and 10. Again, Cousins under pressure. Olivier Vernon there. He's just going to have to dump this one out to Jackson, who's unable to hang on. A lot of drops for Jackson today. Third and 10. Cousins looks underneath the Josh Doxson, and they are unable to pick up the first down. Not sure what they are thinking. And they punt the ball here as well. They are not trying to go for it and win the game, obviously, for some reason. They're just trying to punt the ball. I have no idea why. Your punter's stats does not determine that you're going to win this game. I don't think they know that, as this is Jennings with a huge run up the middle. That's about a 20-yard gain on that run, as Jennings is way over 100, actually 130. He's having a phenomenal game, as that pass for Donnell is just floated out of bounds. Second and 10, another first down run by Jennings, as that was D'Angelo Hall unable to bring him down there. It required more than one guy. Right there, though, Norman stuffs him after a short gain. We're going to look for the screen right here. Jennings hits the outside, and he's actually going to run right into the back, and Will Compton is not going to let him pick up the first down, so we're going to need to do something here. Will Tye, the reliable tight end, gets away from Will Compton, and this is going to be Jennings off the right side. He's going to be stopped in the backfield. Another handoff to Jennings on the outside. Jennings has running room. He's going to get the first down here as he gets away from Will Compton, who's been struggling on this drive. First and 10 underneath the Donnell on the slant, and he gets us inside the 5-yard line at the 2. First and goal. Handoff Jennings. He's going to dive past Will Compton, and he's going to pick up the touchdown. And Jennings with his second rushing touchdown on the day. He is well over 150 yards rushing, and he's just had a dominating day as we are winning 27-15 with 56 seconds left. And the Redskins pretty much did this themselves because they decided to punt it there on fourth down, and they're just simply not going to go anywhere. As there's another flag, and it's going to be on Morgan Moses again, their right tackle. He's unable to hear the snap count because of the noise here at this home game for us. Jordan Reed with a huge play right there, and just too little too late, and he's just unable to do anything as he's been shut down all day. Look at Sims right here. He gets past Thompson. He breaks away from another guy, and he's finally forced out of bounds by Landon Collins. They're going to spike the ball here on the 25. 16 seconds left to go. Cousins under pressure. He's flustered. Fires it to Cromartie. Cromartie intercepts it, and Cromartie brings it all the way back to the 25. His intended target was DeSean Jackson, but that was well underthrown. First and 10. Play action. Fake to Jennings. Manning looks deep. He has Beckham wide open over Breeland and Anicho, and Beckham goes all the way. What a huge 75-yard pass right there by Eli Manning to Odell Beckham Jr., and that just rubs salt in the wound for Josh Norman, who really didn't match up against Odell Beckham Jr., but still, he loses to Beckham, and that is never good for Josh Norman. Cousins had an awful game, just absolutely terrible. Their offense could not do much of anything as we shut them down, and Rashad Jennings, what a game for him. He had over 150 yards rushing. That is absolutely insane. Or maybe somewhere close to that. I'm not sure if it was over. But let's take a look at the highlights right here. This is going to be Sims. Sims had he was their entire offense. It was always Sims with the run or the short pass. They're trying the short passes. Look at Cousins right here, firing a laser to Josh Doxson, and that was like the one thing that went their way. Jennings with that huge run over 70 yards. What a play right there. And then look at Beckham again. This was one-on-one coverage with D'Angelo Hall, and we'll take that any day of the week. And then Beckham right here at the end just gets by everyone. And that is going to be the end of this game. Let's take a look at some of these stats. We have 286 passing yards, 161 rushing yards, and yet we just beat them in literally every single category. We're tied in takeaways, but look at Rashad Jennings, 22 carries, 161 yards, 2 touchdowns. Beckham with 5 receptions, 167 yards, 2 touchdowns. And look at Charles Sims, he led the team in rushing and receptions, but that's going to be this episode, guys. Comment, subscribe, and eat your veggies, go to school. Dan Carfilms out. Peace!